Order! Order! You are an incorrigible delinquent at times. Behave yourself, man!
Jonathan wants to speak to us from Glasgow. Go for it, Jonathan.
Hello, how you doing?
I'm all right. Tell us what you think.
Well, it's just another example of the far left takeover of the BBC and the mainstream media in general, just with an incessant cultural Marxism.
So when you say far left takeover, I mean, when I think of far left, I mean, I think of Corbynistas, right? So I'm not so sure they've taken over the BBC.
No, but I think of far left, I think of the globalists and the agenda that the globalists are trying to promote.
I wonder whether you and I mean the same thing here, Jonathan, and I wonder whether you and I are concerned about the same things. I suspect from your language...
No, I mean, me and you have got completely different views.
Yeah, I know.
You're a committed globalist, so...
Well, explain yourself then, explain. What do you believe in?
Right, what do I believe in?
Yeah.
Well, I'm a gay man, right? But I don't let that define me. I think I'm really against the far-left ideology and the kind of cultural Marxism that's promoted everywhere, particularly in schools and the media. I mean, I'm a gay man, but I'm against the promotion of homosexuality to children.
I'm going to repeat the question, Jonathan. What do you believe in, not what you're opposed to?
Well, I believe in borders. I believe in nationalities.
Right, OK. You believe in borders.
I don't believe in world government.
Do you believe in borders? I believe in the sovereignty of nations. You believe in borders and you believe in nationality. Who do you believe the United Kingdom should be for?
England should be for English. Scotland should be for Scottish, I
would
say.
Who's English and who's Scottish in your definition?
Do you want me to name them all?
No, I mean, can anyone who's born there qualify, or do you think that there's a different criteria?
No, I mean, part of your globalist agenda is a demographic replacement of white people in their own countries.
I can smell it a mile away. I can smell it. I was asking you these questions, Jonathan.
I can smell you. I know your game there. You're a deceptive liar.
Oh, yeah.
And you're a paid propagandist.
Look at that. It's all coming out. You tried to call onto my show to pretend to sympathise with my concerns about this particular one element of the policy going too far, and I have flushed you out, Jonathan.
You've not flushed anybody. Tell us all, Jonathan.
Who do you think this country is for, and who doesn't belong here? Do tell us.
I don't think you belong here, right? I don't think Islam belongs here. I don't belong here either. I mean, you constantly refer to we.
Do you think, Jonathan, you hate this country, you hate the people in England, you're constant anti-white agenda. All right, anti-white. Do you think, Jonathan, this country should be for white people only?
No, not for white people only, no.
Who should it be for?
Well, it should be for, I mean, the people that are indigenous to every country should decide who comes and goes to that country. That doesn't mean nobody can ever come or go again. But what we are opposed to is a massive, deliberately social engineered movement of people.
So the indigenous people get to decide, and those who are, even if they're born here and have citizenship, have less of a say over that. Only the indigenous people, in your definition, should get to decide that.
Not only.
Okay, all right. So who else?
Yeah, I mean, the criteria should really be maybe three generations in.
So I'm not. Nah. So if I'm two generations in, I have a less of a say than you, Jonathan, yeah?
Because, I mean, I think what's happened here, we've went too far in one direction, so new people need to start blaming their countries.
So what's your solution for the fact that you said Islam doesn't belong here and I don't belong here? What's your solution, though, because we're here now?
Well, my solution for Islam, to be honest with you, I mean, ban the halal slaughtered meat.
Well, that doesn't stop me being here, though, does it?
Well, it doesn't stop you being here, no. I mean, I'm not imposing any kind of false methods, but if you do that just now, then... You're not allowed to slaughter meat in that ritualistic manner in this country.
So when you called in, Jonathan, why did you call in pretending you agreed with the point I'm making when it was so easy for me to flush you out and flush out the fact that you're an ethno-nationalist, Jonathan?
You never flushed anything out, right? I'll clearly admit to what I believe in.
Well, evidently, you're prepared to admit to it when you're asked questions, but when I first asked you, what do you believe in?
I'm not ashamed to think that... the national people have sovereignty over our countries. And I'm not ashamed to admit that I know what the globalist plan is, and it's social engineering to replace indigenous peoples of Europe. That's what's happening in every country.
What do you call it? A white genocide? What do you call it?
Well, I mean, that's a term that's used. I mean, you can tell because it's... And diversity means less white people. We all know this. That's basically what the BBC are doing there. I mean, it's different from...
Is it specifically designed to get...
in Scotland as well.
Do you think there's a specific policy here to basically remove white people? Is that what you think?
That's a long-term plan. It's been written down for over 100 years.
Who wrote it down?
Well, there's various people throughout the UN.
Where has this been written? Can you point to me somewhere where it's written that there's a specific plan to remove white people?
Well, have you heard of the Kalergi plan for the destruction of white Europeans in their own homeland?
Why? No, I'm asking you to point me to this stuff because I'm not particularly...
I'll point you to that end. Have you referred to the Kalergi plan?
Is anybody currently in the world or in history close to your vision and what you think needs to happen? Who do you support politically?
Is this you going to bring in your secret Hitler weapon, is it? No, I'm opposed to fascism because fascism is also a far-left ideology.
Okay,
I believe in constitutional republics.
That's not what I asked you.
Don't try and play your wee implication.
Jonathan, I asked you a very specific and direct question. Is there anybody in history or in current times that you believe represents your political vision?
Well, probably the founding fathers of America.
Sorry?
Probably the founding fathers of America, American Constitution.
The founding fathers of America.
That's the best political document that's ever been conceived by man so far.
What it
ensures, it's got different kind of protections against government tyranny, which is what the far left and fascism. I mean, fascism is a far left ideology. We know this as much as you try and spin it. Mm. I'm against totalitarian governments, right? I don't hate anybody. I don't hate any group of people. I mean, I really, really don't like globalists, right? But I mean, I don't hate them, right? But I think Scotland should be Scottish, France should be French, Nigeria should be Nigeria, Japan should be Japanese, right? So there's no denying, if you move a million people deliberately, right, if you socially engineer it, the mass movement of people, then the country's going to change. And you've admitted this yourself. You'll make casual things, but the demographics have changed. Why have the demographics changed? Because it's been socially engineered. And that has always been the globalist plan. If you look at the Kalergi plan, it says the European man of the future will be a negroid race, much like the ancient Egyptians. That's why we see the constant promotion of miscegenation in adverts as well, because there's an agenda behind it.
Miscegenation and negroid race in Europe.
The negroid race is a quote for the Kalergi plan, yeah, right? Yeah, that's what it says in this document.
Okay.
That's not my word, right? That's in the document. Yeah. I'm quoting directly from one of the architects of the European Union.
Jonathan, do you not feel that you sound somewhat bonkers on radio?
No, I don't. No. You sound like a lunatic, man.
I do, yeah. Do you not feel
a dialogue, that's what you are.
I'm a what, sorry?
An ideologue.
An ideologue. Oh, okay. All right. Thank you very much for calling in there, Jonathan. Pleasure to hear such entertaining views. I'm sure that you'll probably call in again. Please, next time, don't try and hide your views by pretending you agree with me on a topic just because it happens to coalesce with one element of your world plan. Just come out with it straight away. We're going to go to Dave on the line from Bridgend. Tell us what you think, Dave.
Hi, Maajid. Yeah, I'm calling about the BBC thing, and it seems to me that we're at the thin end of a wedge here, leading to us being compelled to say or do the right thing. We've lived with political correctness for, I don't know, 10, 20 years, but this now seems like it's the thin end of the wedge where we're actually being forced to do it.
Mm.
And I think that's a danger. I'm a liberal-minded person.
Mm.
And it's no longer good enough to be liberal. I think, you know, the best analogy is like a mountain slope. We've had to have equality. And it's, as you go up the mountain slope, it's perhaps harder and harder to get to the point where we have absolute equality. But when you reach the ridge of the mountain,
yeah,
and you get this compulsion, it's a very quick drop to the other side that ends up in fascism.
And that's, of course, that's precisely, Dave, what I'm warning against, that with the best of intentions, we may end up basically doing ourselves a disservice, because the cause here is clearly good and noble. It's inclusive. It's important to be inclusive and diverse, despite what the last caller thinks or says. And yet there's a danger that with those good intentions, we can push it too far.